Guys, today we're looking into some of the stuff you can do to deal with playing football in the rain. Now, as we probably all know, playing in the rain is a whole lot different than playing outside when it's nice and dry and sunny. So we sat down in the WebTV team and looked into some of the stuff you can do when it's actually pouring down outside. And that's both in terms of your playing style and some of the gear that's pretty good to have. Now, the first thing I want to mention is that the playing surface outside is going to be a little more wet and fast when it's raining, which means that you should try and let the ball do the work for you, because it's simply going to move faster on the surface than it will when it's dry, which is pretty obvious as to why. And then, of course, it's also worth keeping in mind that the ball obviously is also going to be wet and thus a little bit more slippery. So stuff like sole rolls or other really delicate feinschmecker details that require a little bit more grip and control over the ball, they might have a bit of a higher tendency to go wrong. So unless you've got the technique of a god, well, you should be a little bit wary. So keep it simple, keep it fast, and you might just have the advantage. Keeping that in mind, it's also a good idea to always shoot low, because of the fact, again, that the pitch is extremely fast, giving the keeper less time to react. And then, of course, there's also the fact that you can get that really fast and extremely treacherous bounce if the ball kind of skids off the faster surface, making it a complete nightmare from a keeper's perspective. And some of the goalkeepers I talked to about this actually said that this low, kind of bouncy, skiddy ball off the surface is one of their most hated shots to face. So get it right, keep it low, get it on target, and we're talking about a very dangerous situation here, if you can pull it off. It's also important to keep your gear in order for when it's raining outside and the pitches are soft, wet, and muddy. And for that, I always say it's a really good idea to have a pair of SG boots, because in the rain, your traction and your grip in the ground simply goes out the window, which means that you might risk losing your footing and slipping, which really kinda sucks. So getting a pair of SG boots is always a good idea, because the thing about SG boots is that they're made with fewer studs than normal FT boots are, which means that you get a lot more pressure on each stud, so they can penetrate the ground a lot more deeply by themselves. And also, of course, they're longer than FG studs are, which gives another more natural, deeper penetration. And that combined, in turn, means that you get more grip and traction in the ground, which means less slipping around. So everybody wins, of course. Now, if you're feeling like a true boss, you can also go out and get yourself a pair of anti-clog boots, which means that, as the name suggests, it prevents your sole from clogging up, so you don't have to carry around the weight of half the pitch underneath your boots. And also, of course, your studs are kept free, so they can actually provide the grip and traction that you need in order to stay on your feet to create the magic that you can do, right? It's also not a bad idea to get yourself a good pair of shin pads and some other protection gear if you're into that sort of thing, because again, the pitch is going to be wet and slippery and tackles might be flying all over the place. And if some Viking hits you with 200 miles an hour, it's good to be protected enough to know that you can actually get back on your feet without your legs pointing in 5 different directions. So if you want to know how to protect yourself more, you can go and check out my top 5 protection hacks by clicking the eye on your screen right now. Now, another thing that I also usually do is that when it's raining really, really hard, I usually bring 2 pairs of socks to a match. So if my socks are completely soaked, I can always change to a fresh pair during halftime, which not only will actually improve the grip in your socks, especially if you're using grip socks, either the Sturelli ones or the Falco ones that are my favorites, but also because there's nothing better than going out of a wet pair of socks and into a dry, fresh pair. Trust me, you're gonna feel like the king of the castle. But not only is grip and safety important, you also want to deal with the water itself. And first, in terms of choosing the right boot, I always say that given the choice, you should try and go with a pair of synthetic boots, simply because synthetic materials and uppers will absorb a lot less water than leather boots will, which means that you'll actually have a lighter boot throughout the entire match. Of course, they're not going to be completely water repellent, but if you get a pair of leather boots and you've ever worn it in the wet, you will know that they get soaked and they get really, really heavy. So I always prefer to use synthetics in the rain. Now, another thing you also might want to consider is that if it's really wet outside, get a pair of boots that has a lot of grip to the upper, so it won't feel as if the ball is constantly slipping away. Because for me, there's nothing worse than actually feeling like you're not in control of the ball, because it's simply just too slippery. Now, some people might say that I could also just try and improve my actual ball control, and they might be right, but just keep it in mind. But even after you're done playing, you're back inside, you're nice, dry, and warm, the rain can actually still be kind of a nuisance, because if you keep your boots in your bag, you don't take them out, well, they're gonna stay wet, they're gonna get moldy, and actually that's gonna be really, really rough on the bonding and the seams keeping everything together. So if you don't dry your boots properly, well, you might risk them falling apart a lot quicker than you want them to, which means that you're gonna have to go and get new boots, which is expensive, you don't want that, yada, yada, yada. Take your boots out of your bag, dry them properly. And you can do that by slapping a few pieces of newspaper inside the boots to really drag out the moisture and potentially a tea bag for the smell. Because the smell is also a byproduct of having wet boots, and I think we all know that, and nobody wants it. Ugh. So remember the tea bag. And what you can also do is that you want to dry your boots naturally. Do not put them in the tumbler or over the heater. They need to dry at room temperature. Slap a few pieces of newspaper inside and your boots, and in turn your wallet, is gonna thank you. So there you go, my friends, a few pieces of advice on what you should do if you're playing in the rain. Now, I do realize that there are a lot of you out there playing at a really high level, who are probably also a lot better than I am, who have a lot of experiences with playing in the rain. So if you have any tips that you want to share, because sharing is caring, you can do so in the comment section right down below, so we can all get better at playing in the wet. Now, of course, if you also want to gear up, get some SG boots, you can actually have some traction, you can grab a pair by clicking the link right over here. Of course, you can also go and watch some of our Wicked Top 5 videos with tutorials and tips and all that jazz by clicking the playlist right down here. And of course, don't forget to go and subscribe with the notifications on, of course, to not miss a single of our almost daily football videos. And guys, I guess I'm gonna see you later. With that said, signing off, cheerio.